What's up everybody, Garden City Aviation here, back with another video. This is the NG Models February 2021 releases. Without further ado, let's get started. So first we're going to start with the 1-400 models, and then we're going to head down to the 1-200 models. So starting off with the 1-400 models, we have this American Airlines 737-800. This is in the chrome livery. Looks pretty nice, and they actually, NG actually did add a gray bottom. I know that this actually is pretty new, as NG's older American chrome aircraft, like chrome 737s, they have just gray bottom. So they made the bottom for the aircraft chrome, so that's actually pretty cool. But yeah, registration is November 936 Alpha November, or N936 AM, and the price is $45.59, and of course it is 1-400 scale. Moving on down the line, we have another American 737-800. It's basically the same as the last one, except this one is not chrome. This is just a regular American 737-800. There's no winglets. The registration is November 955 AM, Alpha November, or N955 AM. And yeah, it's basically the same as the other aircraft, except the back, from what it looks like, has a chrome bottom too. But yeah, that is the model, and it is 1-400, of course, and the MSRP is $45.59. Moving on down the line, we have another Alaska in NG's releases. Now, the reason why I'm saying this is, lately, NG has been releasing a lot of Alaska aircraft. October of 2020, they released the 737-800 in the Honoring Those Who Serve. Now they're releasing the, I think it's Spirit of Boeing, what it's called. It's either Spirit of Seattle or Spirit of Boeing. It's basically an Alaska 737-800 with the Boeing house livery put on it, if you know what I mean. Like, when Boeing ever when they release an aircraft, they just put this livery, except, you know, just a blank aircraft with this livery. So yeah, but yeah, it's in the Spirit of Seattle. I believe it's called the Spirit of Seattle. Let's double check. Yeah, Spirit of Seattle. It is with split scimitar winglets, and looks pretty cool. I actually don't need this aircraft. It's gonna be nice to have, like, it would look nice in my collection, but I don't need it. Alaska fly the 737-900 and the 700. They occasionally send the 737-800, but I already have another Alaska 737-800. It's in the Honoring Those Who Serve. I'll put a card up right now. I'll put up a card right now. It'll just be, you know, sitting there. But basically, I did a review on that, so I already have Alaska 737-800, so I don't need this. And of course, you guys know me, I don't really collect retro models. But yeah, moving on online, we actually have two Boeing 747 SPs, or I think it means special product, I don't know. But we have two Boeing 747 SPs. Starting off with the first one, we have an American 747 SP. This is in, like, a chrome, I think it's going to be in chrome. I think it's chrome. Just a chrome American 747 SP. Looks pretty nice. Personally, from my experience, I've never seen their 747 SP molds, NGs, so I have no clue what it's going to look like, if it's accurate or not, and all that stuff, so I don't know. But yeah, that is a American Boeing 747 SP. It's 1-400, and the price is $57. By the way, the Alaska is $45.59. But yeah, this is a really, really, really focused release. This is, I feel like they're really, it's focusing on American collectors like me. They're focusing on North American collectors, you know, because you have Pan Am, American, and all that stuff. Now, I know that a few days, these releases actually came out on RM Model Store a few days back, but I decided to wait till NG's official release to debut these models, like, to show you guys which models these are, because this is NG's official release. I didn't go with our model store, I just decided to go on NG's website and do it from there. But yeah, moving on down the line, we have another Pan Am 747 SP. This is in the China Clipper livery, just a normal Pan Am 747 with the words China Clipper, and I believe it's Mandarin written below it. It's too small in the picture for me. But yeah, this is what it looks like. But yeah, NG really have been milking the 747 mold lately. I know that in November, in their November release, they had like two 747 SPs. They released, I believe they released one in their October releases. They have a lot of 747s. They're releasing a lot of 747 SPs. But yeah, this is a Pan Am 747 SP. This is what it looks like. Registration is number 540 Papa Alpha and 540 PA. And the price is $57. So something that's actually pretty interesting about this is, of course I don't need it, but something, and I'm not gonna get it either, but something that's really interesting about this is NG, a few months back, like I think in December of 2020, around 2 months before they released this, before this was in the release, they actually were looking for an image of this exact aircraft, the China Clipper one, up close. They posted an advertisement on it for Instagram, like anybody has a close-up picture of it. And so yeah, now it's finally being released, that kind of makes sense. But yeah, moving on the line, we have the one of two Asian aircraft, the only 1-400 Asian aircraft for this release. We have this Garuda Indonesia, Airbus A330-300, I believe. It's a 200. It's an Airbus A330-200. This is what it looks like. Looks pretty nice. Registration, it's just regular Garuda Indonesia, but registration is Papa Golf, Golf Papa Oscar, PKGPO, and it is 1-400, of course, and the price is $55. Moving on online, we have this, the only, and it's quite rare, too, that NG release a, whatchamacallit, military aircraft. This is a French Army Air Force AC-30-200, I believe. I keep making a mistake between these. It's a MRT. It's a KC-30. It's not a 200. It's a KC-30 MRTT. But this is what it looks like. It has the words Army de l'Air. I'm not even going to try to pronounce that. I think it means French Air Force. But yeah, that's what it looks like. It is just a military AC-30-200. Like I said, I don't need it. But yeah, the registration on this thing is 041. Or Foxtrot Uniform Juliet Charlie Golf, or FUJCG. Scale 1-400, and the price is $57. Moving on down the line, we have two L-1011-500, starting off with this one. This is an Air Lanka L-1011-500. Now, I believe Air Lanka, they were the predecessor. They were before, they came before Sri Lankan, which is the national airline of Indonesia. So I believe this is before that. But I have no clue. I'm not really into Asian aviation. I'm more interested in, you know, African and European and North American aviation. But yeah, it's an Air Lankan L-1011-500. Looks nice. The registration is 4 Romeo Uniform Lima Alpha, or 4 RULA. Scale 1-400, and the price is $55. Moving on to the other L-1011. Sorry. I said there's two L-1011-500s. No, it's one L-1011-500 and one L-1011-100. Is the L-1011-100. This is a Gulf Air L-1011-100. Looks nice. Looks pretty nice. This is going to be popular with retro collectors. I know that as a fact. Like, I have a few friends who collect retro models. And I know that one of them really, really wants this. So I can see why NG released this. Just in Gulf Air's retro livery. Because I think this is from back when the aircraft was operating. But it's an L-1011-100. So it looks like registration is Alpha 40 Tango Yankee, or A40TY, and it is scale 1-400, and the price is $55. But yeah, both of these are new molds, the 1-200 ARJ21-700, that's OTT Airlines, and the one that we just saw, which is the Gulf Air. Both of these are their new molds, but yeah. Moving on to the only 1-200 scale aircraft for this release, we have an OTT Airlines Comac ARJ21-700. Now, was it last month? I think it was last month. Yeah, it was last month that NG did release this in 1-400. So NG sort of are following Gemini's route in the fact that they're releasing models in one scale, and then the next month they're releasing another. This is an OTT Airlines Comac ARJ21-700. This is in 1-200. It's the same as the 1-400, same registration too, which is Bravo 123 Alpha, or B123A. So it looks pretty nice. like I said, the registration is Bravo 123 Alpha. It's scale 1 to 200, and the price is $72. And I don't really need anything from this release. This release is sort of dead to me. Only thing that I probably will get is an American 737-800 in chrome. But yeah, that's really the only thing that I would get if I had to pick something from this release. But yeah. That being said, that does conclude this video. If you guys like the video, please like, subscribe, turn on the notification bell. Comment down below, what are you getting from this release? Or if you're not getting anything at all. But yeah, once again, thank you for watching today's video, and I'll see you in the next video. As always, goodbye.